Welcome to Polk Place. Joining us today is a very, very serious shelter and an amazing resource with us here in Polk County, and that is the George W. Harris Jr. Shelter for Youth and Children. And I want to introduce our guest today and jump right into this topic. Joining us today is Mark Wickham, CEO of Youth and Family Alternatives Incorporated. Welcome, Mark.
Well, thank you. Thanks for having us.
Absolutely. Also joining us is Polk County Commissioner Melanie Bell. Welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
And Glenn Parkinson with the George W. Harris Jr. Shelter for Youth and Children. Welcome. Well, I am so excited that you're here today. I know that we could probably speak for hours to the importance of the program that you offer through the George W. Harris Shelter. And Mark, I'd kind of like to get started with you as the Youth and Family Alternatives CEO for this area, and maybe share with us a little bit about the history of that great organization.
Wow. The history of the organization is we're 44 years old. We've been providing children and family services for 44 years. And we are in 13 counties in this region. And in particular, working in Polk County for since 1994, and we're really ecstatic over the level of collaboration and partnership that happens here in this county. It's absolutely fantastic, and it's a model. It's a model across for Florida in terms of how do you bring in organizations and not-for-profits and government and private business to be able to provide services to children and families. And in Polk County, we're so excited about what happens here, not just with the George Harris program, but in our partner and collaboration with all the parties, in particular Melanie, who's been highly supportive of our organization and the George Harris shelter for a number of years.
Wonderful. Yes. And, you know, Glenn, when I think about the George Harris Shelter and I hear about the wonderful things that happen from several resources in our county,
That's good to hear.
And I know, right? And I'm hearing more and more and more, which tells me that you're doing amazing work and you're serving children that have definite needs. Can you tell us a little bit about just what it looks like in your shelter? Kind of share that story of what it looks like with your children and maybe how many children we're serving.
Yeah, well, we're a relatively small program. It's a 24-bed facility. It's one building. We've been providing services out here at that particular location since 2007. And even though it's a 24-bed shelter with 12 beds for girls and 12 beds for boys, we see about 600 kids a year. They come to us 24 hours a day. We'll get kids 3-4 o'clock in the morning that are brought from everywhere. They could be runaways from out of county, across the state. They could be kids who are in the care of the Department of Children and Families that need an emergency shelter placement because they've just been newly removed from the shelter, or excuse me, from their home, and they need a place to stay. So things happen pretty relatively very, very fast. And oftentimes the kids, when they come to us, they're a little bit confused and a little bit scared. And we try to get them settled in as quickly as possible and make sure that they're fed and they get into a nice clean bed and we take care of them.
Commissioner Bell, can you tell us about the importance of a program this substantial to the residents of our community?
Well, it's very important, and we're just so fortunate to have it here in this county. We call it, you know, home away from home. When these children are taken out of their home and placed into the George Harris Shelter, like Glenn was saying earlier, these children are scared straight. Can you imagine being an 11-year-old and you're taken away from your parents because you're being abused and you need to go into a home? But we call this the best kept secret in Polk County. We don't want it the best kept secret. We want people to know, you know, that we do have this shelter here, and the collaboration that we were talking about earlier with businesses getting involved for kids, where, you know, these children come from an environment where they have never been exposed to food like we have.
Right.
I know last year when there was a certain group that gave them, actually it was the cricket club in Bartow that gave them a Christmas party, they served them meatballs and shrimp. these kids had never seen that before, and we just take it for granted. And it was sort of like a, you know, a hors d'oeuvre meal, and they were just amazed with the food that, you know, because they're used to cafeteria food coming in and out there. But it's so important to have this shelter available to our children, and like he was talking earlier, from children all over the state to be brought in.
And I think that's important to note, that it's children from all over the state. It's not just our county, which we're fortunate to have such a shelter in our county for sure. But to have children brought in from all over the state, what is some of the time frames, Glenn, that you could share with us? A child comes in to your shelter and they're there for how long? And what is that determining factor as to how long they're there?
Well, every kid's got a story, and we need to find out what that story is. And depending on what the circumstances of their coming, you get a game plan together pretty quickly and figure out who needs to be involved, whether or not there's a parent or the Department of Children and Families, the Department of Juvenile Justice. They might have some charges. But there's some real basic stuff that we have to take care of first, again, is make sure that they've got some food in their stomach and a place to stay. And you know, a clean bed, that's first and foremost, and make sure they have an opportunity to take a shower and get settled in. And then the story starts to unfold, and we take care of the kids depending on what their needs are at the time. We do a couple of things after we get them settled in. If they're going to be with us for a while, they do go to Bartow High School, middle school, or any of the local schools around here. We do get them settled in, and so we got to figure out their needs pretty quickly.
Absolutely. And I would estimate that in a nonprofit business serving these types of needs, that that's an expensive endeavor. Let's talk a little bit about collaborations and how that comes together for your organization. Mark, I'm going to kind of turn to you for this. If you could share with us, how does that collaboration even begin for an organization like the George Hare Shelter?
Well, Melanie, Commissioner Bell, clearly is a person who's well-known, well-respected in our community, who really speaks highly of what we do as within the shelter. And I think her presence and her leadership has really helped to increase the knowledge, number one, and two, what we do with children in our community. So I think having political leaders who are involved, and not just by saying it, but being there. Melanie comes to our shelter, spends time there, listens to the stories, gets involved, rallies other people within this community to help support what happens. So the champions are you know, start with the leaders. And then from there, the other heroes that are there are our staff. Our staff are second to none. I can't ever thank them enough for all that they do. The support that they give these children is amazing. And when I think about it, and I go there and I spend time with Glenn and the staff and the children who are there, there's true love and there's true support. Mm-hmm. And you can't ask for anything better than that.
No, definitely not. Certainly in environments like that, your staff would be maybe the love that those children are seeing. And absolutely, staff become heroes, volunteers are heroes. Melanie, with regard to, you do so much, you just do so much, but we have a commission that does so much with regard to collaboration. I want to say probably it was Commissioner Dantzler that first made me think about the George Harris program. We were talking about different shelters and different things in our community. And it's nice to hear that this program exists and we know that it's out there. How do we help share your message more? How do we get your message out?
Well, I know Mark was saying, you know, it's important to have leaders involved in it, but this county is a caring county. Mm-hmm. If we put the wish list out that we're having a birthday party for a child that's turning 14 years old, that's never blown out a candle in her life or his life, and you think, well, how has that happened? Well, that child's probably been in and out of foster homes their whole life, and every time comes time for a birthday, they've ended up in a home and they don't realize it's their birthday. So when we put out a wish list, say we're going to have a birthday party for a certain child there, the people just come out of the woodwork saying, what can I do? And, mm-hmm. and so I think the importance is talking about it and keeping the awareness out there, but that we do have children in need in this county. And what a great ministry it is to be able to go there and minister to these children. And he talked about the staff, and yes, they're the first faces they see when you know, they enter the doors. And there are some fantastic staff members that work mm-hmm. over there that probably put in more than you know, a 40-hour week just giving to these children and all. But we, when I attend the monthly board meetings, Glenn will usually bring in a child and. If the child wants to come in and tell their story, mm-hmm. and I don't think anybody ever leaves without tears flowing down their face because these children do not ask for that walk of life. Mm-hmm. It's so sad, but you know, talking about it in the community, and we do have a great board that cares right now. All five commissioners mm-hmm. certainly care about this shelter over here. And coming up in November, we're planning on having an open house where we'll bring community leaders in throughout the Tri-County area. We send invitations out, and I believe this is going to be our fourth year that we've had this, and that gets the word out. If you could just come and take a tour and see what we're doing there at the shelter, you know, people leave there saying, what can I do?
Absolutely, and we all get so busy and we all get so focused to the thing we're working on, and sometimes we don't get out and take that trip and make that visit, and we do need to see mm-hmm. the George Harris shelter. We all need to see that shelter. Glenn, I would like to ask you real quickly, funding is an issue. It is an issue for all of us in the nonprofit world. Mm-hmm. Tell me the importance of funding and share with our viewers what you need in funding for your shelter.
We certainly need as much financial support as we can get. We pretty much remained stable for the last 8 years. We do with what we have, we make sure we take care of the kids. You simply can't say no, we're closed at the end. If there's a homeless kid, we're gonna take care of them. The budget is always very, very tight. I do want to point out a couple things. There's been a foundation, the GiveWell Foundation, along with George Jenkins Foundation, has recently given us $20,000 for a new vehicle. That stuff helps. When Melanie and the Cricket Club come out and they meet with the kids, those pieces help. It's not just about money, but it's about caring and healing. Mm-hmm. And what I wanted to point out is, where in what county would you have a county commissioner coming in and talking to the children there? Right. That in itself is very, very healing. She's warm and wonderful with the kids, and I can never say enough for that, so I had to put that plug in.
Huh. Absolutely, so. Absolutely. We all have the Melanie plug because we love her, absolutely. Well, I cannot thank you enough for coming out and sharing about the George Harris Shelter and Youth and Family Alternatives. Mark, welcome. And we want our Polk County residents to know what you're doing, and we want them to get involved.
We are having an open house in November.
Open house is in November.
Yes.
Very good.
Prior to Thanksgiving, and if you can give us a call at the shelter and we can get kind of an estimate of who's coming, that'd be
okay.
great.
Okay.
One more plug. If anybody out there has extra tickets to ball games or bowling or movies, or they just want to donate, get involved, these children appreciate it. And
wonderful.
Things, like I said, things that we take for granted or our children took mm-hmm. for granted, these children, it's the best day of their life if they can do something. So if anybody out there has any ideas or would like to donate or give their time to the shelter, we welcome.
Glenn, I have another question for you. We talk a lot about websites, and I know we have websites. Do mm-hmm. you have a Facebook page that we can share with our community?
Youth and Family Alternatives has, we have a website, and I believe that you can just Google in Youth and Family Alternatives, and there's links to us.
Okay.
And I can even be reached that way.
Wonderful.
Facebook connections are on that page.
Yes. We do not have a separate Facebook page mm-hmm. for the George Harris Youth Shelter.
Okay.
However, what I do recommend people do is we do have some videos on YouTube. They're a little bit dated, but they're still really good. And you can Google in the George Harris Youth Shelter and see a little bit about us there.
Wonderful. Thank you again for joining
Thank
us
you.
Today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The George Harris Shelter is a very important and vital part of what is happening in Polk County and statewide and out of state for children and families in need. The George Harris Youth Shelter is open 365 days a year and is never closed. Their open house will be in November. For more information, you can contact the shelter directly at 863-595-0220. This program is a program within Youth and Family Alternatives, and Youth and Family Alternatives operates three shelters in the Tampa Bay area. Shelter services include 24-hour availability, youth supervision, food and clothing, life skills education, crisis counseling, individual and family counseling, recreation and leisure activities, and case management services. Be sure to contact the George W. Harris Shelter for Youth and Children, 863-595-0220.